Good evening.
Good evening.
Welcome to the Easter Cantata put on by the King of Glory Choir under the direction of Mr. Bruce Erickson. I am Pastor Jen Quanbeck. I'm one of the pastors that serves this congregation, and on behalf of all of the members and friends of King of Glory, we welcome you tonight to this special performance. Tonight's performance is based on the song, The Lord of the Dance, and the lyrics of that are on the back of your bulletin tonight. And throughout these songs, you will hear different portions of Jesus' life, and they relate to the different verses in the song. And we do know that today is the first day of Holy Week, Palm Sunday, and one of the most, perhaps the most meaningful week of the year for Christians. And despite it not yet being Monday, Thursday, or Good Friday, or Easter, tonight's concert will conclude with the choir singing the pieces from the resurrection, which are beautiful pieces that we hope will inspire and uplift you as you grow in your faith this week. There will be a reception afterwards, and so we invite you to stay and join with the choir. In fact, if you are so moved tonight that you say, man, I would like to sing with this choir next year, you just pull Bruce aside and say, let's do this again. And I'm sure he would be delighted to welcome you. We love to have folks come and sing with us. Finally, tonight, on the very back table in the sanctuary, the choir has selected the group called Love and Sunshine Ministries, which is a ministry here in Billings that serves pregnant teens. And so the offering that you give tonight, if you are so moved, will be donated to that ministry. So with that, welcome to I Am the Lord of the Dance.
For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish but have eternal life. For God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but to save the world through him. Through his Son, God's word became flesh. In him was life, that life was the light of all mankind. So the life of Jesus began. He grew up in a town called Nazareth. Even as a child, he was filled with wisdom. He grew in stature and became strong, and the grace of God was on him.
Jesus was baptized too. And as he was praying, heaven was opened, and the Holy Spirit descended on him in bodily form like a dove, and a voice came from heaven. You are my Son, whom I love. With you, I am well pleased.
But who believed the message, and to whom has the arm of the Lord been revealed? He grew up like a tender shoot, and like a root out of dry ground. He had no beauty or majesty to attract us to him, nothing in his appearance that we should desire him. He was despised and rejected for mankind, a man of suffering and familiar with pain. Like one from whom people hide their faces, he was despised and held in low esteem.
I want Jesus to walk
that night in Jerusalem, Jesus shared the Passover feast with his disciples. He broke bread for them, shared the cup with them, and asked them to think of him whenever they did this. Jesus spoke of his enemies, of his death, and even told the disciples that one of them would betray him before the night was through. They refused to believe it could be them, and they all declared their loyalty and undying love. They sang a hymn together and then departed for the Mount of Olives, where Jesus went to Gethsemane.
During his ministry on earth, Jesus had amassed many enemies. Because he performed miracles of healing on the Sabbath, some Pharisees accused him of breaking the Sabbath law. They sought to kill him because he insisted that God was his Father, making himself equal with God. That night, after Passover, as Jesus was praying in the garden, Roman soldiers came and arrested him. He was accused, tried, and ultimately convicted of crimes he didn't commit. Jesus was whipped, mocked, and forced to carry a cross on his back to Golgotha, where he was to be crucified. when they came to the skull, place called the skull, they crucified him there, along with two criminals, one on either side. Jesus cried out, "Father, forgive them, for they do not know what they are doing."
One of the criminals who hung there hurled insults to Jesus. "Aren't you the Messiah? Save yourself and us." But the other criminal rebuked him, saying, "We are punished justly, for we are getting what our deeds deserve. But this man has done nothing wrong." Then he said, "Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom." Jesus replied, "Today you will be with me in paradise."
It was now about noon, and darkness came over the whole land until 3 p.m, for the sun stopped shining, and the curtain of the temple was torn in two. Jesus called out with a loud voice, "Father, into your hands I commit my spirit." When he had said this, he breathed his last.
The dance goes on still. It goes on in the hearts of believers and in the lives of his followers. His crucifixion was not without meaning. He was pierced for our transgressions. He was crushed for our iniquities. The punishment punishment that brought us peace was on him, and by his wounds we are healed. Yes, the dance goes on. In hope that sends a shining ray far down the future's broadening way, in peace that only Christ can give, with thee, O Master, let us live.
See you.
The third day after his crucifixion, friends of Jesus went to visit the tomb where he was buried, only to find it empty. Two men in gleaming clothes said to them, "Why do you look for the living among the dead? He is not here. He is risen." And upon his resurrection, Christ became more than Lamb of God. He became Christ, the conqueror. He came to earth, Emmanuel, and left the earth, Redeemer, Lord of all, Lord of hosts, Lord of glory, and yes, Lord of the dance. Christ is the incarnation of the piper, calling us to the dance of eternal life. He came down from heaven in love and grace. He endured the cross so we could all move together in sync with God's divine plan. His life, his death, resurrection were carefully choreographed by God and selflessly performed for us.
Dance then, whenever you may be. I'll live in you if you'll live in me.
Up from heaven in the dance of the earth.
Thank you. Thank you all for being here this evening.